Shall I start?
We welcome Sri Damodar Mauzo ji from India. He is a very renowned writer. South Asian Online Literary Conference organized by Sahitya Academy in collaboration of Foswal. This session is a fiction session. And now I request Damodar Mauzo ji to kindly chair this session, because unfortunately the writers from Afghanistan, they could not join now. So I request Damodar Mauzo ji to please continue.
Thank you, and namaskar everybody. I am Damodar Mauzo, a short fiction writer, also a novelist. I write in Konkani, the official language of Goa, the state to which I belong. As an activist writer, I strongly defend the freedom of expression. The story that I'm going to read is the shortest story that I have ever written. Sprout is a commentary on the present day scenario, where a progressive thought is always challenged. Sprout is a commentary on the present day scenario where a progressive thought is generally disputed and resisted. It is an analogy where I assert that a progressive thought, however attempted to be crushed, will never die. The short story goes like this. Sprout. It is roughly translated into English by my granddaughter, Riya Kirtani. So here it goes, Sprout. While reading a book, I came across a thought, quite a profound one. That nudging thing would not let me sleep, no matter how hard I tried. It didn't give up, so I simply decided to sleep with it. When I woke up in the morning, I found that this thought had sprouted. So I rushed with it to my front yard in order to plant it. However, I knew that the soil in my own yard was not quite productive, while my neighbor's land was very fertile. Besides, he liked gardening also. So I crossed over the fence and carefully planted the tiny sprout in my neighbor's yard. Even before it rained, the little sprout drew nutrients from the land and bloomed to become a plant, a tree. Soon it was a tree that bore flowers and fruits. The neighbor was delighted. I was then surprised to learn that the fruits had therapeutic value, medicinal value, that provided an instant cure for many ailments. People flocked at the neighbor's door, asking him to give them some fruits. The generous neighbor never sent away anyone empty-handed. Whenever he was at a private get-together or at a public meeting, the neighbor tended to share his fruits with the people. News started popping up about this healing fruit. Day in and day out, the stories were afloat. Someone who could not see well had a clear and effective vision. A confused soul claimed to have gained a newfound understanding. Someone who had been faltering to see the path clearly now got the foresight to visualize what was coming. A person whose intelligence had gathered dust found the wheels turning again. Even someone with severe brain fever was cured. What surprised me the most was when I saw Mr. X, a person known for his crooked ways, was now most well-natured, as good as Mr. A1. Even the abusive Mr. Y and Mr. Z, who always mouth profanities, were unrecognizable with their newfound persona of piousness. Before long, the fruit had become popular on Facebook, number of its followers increasing with every passing day. Nevertheless, all good things always face an alternate viewpoint. The disapproving frowns gradually started rising. Someone had severe stomach ache from just the smell of the fruit. Some were hit by indigestion. Some others' migraines had worsened. Some started throwing up at the smell of the fruit, while some were hit by insomnia. When things became worrisome, the affected people held a meeting and decided to pay my neighbor a visit. "Do not go around distributing these fruits. Do not even let people take away them," they said. When the angry men found the neighbor not paying any heed to their plea, they saw to it that the fruits were legally banned. They spread rumors that the seed was smuggled from the enemy country, giving people a reason to troll the neighbor for it. Such international activities will not be tolerated by our Bharat Premi Sena, the patriots vowed. The perpetrators then realized to their chagrin that the neighbor had the name Bharat, so they decided to look for a new name for their outfit. One day, I overheard of their conspiracy to teach my neighbor a lesson. When I called on him and cautioned him about it, he simply laughed. Soon afterwards, in the dread of a dark night, I heard frightful sounds in my neighborhood. I felt a chill in my spine, and I could sense truckloads of people gathered there. I plugged my ears and tried to sleep. I envisaged my neighbor put to sleep for good. In no time, I could sense the sparks flying, hear the embers ticking, and feel the heat on my skin. Did this set the house on fire? It was a lot later in the wee hours that the spell subsided. Yet, I could not get myself to fall asleep. The thought I had found in the book kept nagging me. The next day, gauging the situation, I solemnly made my way over to my neighbor's house. He was in a murky mood. It was not his house. It was the tree that was in ashes. "They should have just killed me instead. Why the innocent tree? They incinerated it along with its flowers, fruits, roots," he said. I wiped his tears and quietly walked away without even a fleeting look at the burnt tree. As I reached home, I suddenly had an inkling of doubt. I examined closely and looked. The thought that was nagging me at night had grown a sprout. That is the end of my story. Thank you, Ajit ji. Thank you, Mr. Rao, Dr. Rao, and the Faswal Initiative. Thank you for this opportunity given to me to read a short story.
Thank you, Damodar Mauju ji. बहुत ही अच्छे तरीके से आपने बातें रखी. इस सत्र में हमारे बीच में मोहम्मद मंसूर नसीमी साहब को अफगानिस्तान से होना था. उन्होंने अपना वीडियो भेजा है. मैं अपने साथी अवधेश से रिक्वेस्ट करता हूँ कि कृपया उस वीडियो को चलाएं.
No sound.
Just a minute. Sound nahi aa raha. साउंड क्यों नहीं आता यहां तो साउंड दे रहा है
Hello everybody. Who is a Sufi? The Sufi is a lover of God and like any other lover. He proves his love by constant remembrance of his beloved. The purpose of remembering God is to focus
तकनीकी दिक्कत आ रही है यहाँ तो आवाज शो हो रही थी लेकिन उसमें नहीं आ पा रही थी इसलिए अभी हम इस सत्र को यहीं पर संपन्न करते हैं। मैं दामोदर मावजो जी को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देता हूं इस सत्र में बहुत ही अच्छी कहानी के लिए, और अजीत कौर जी का भी बहुत आभार, वो हमारे सभी सत्रों को बहुत ही सम्मान और प्रेम के साथ सभी लेखकों को सुन रही हैं, और मैं उनके प्रति भी साहित्य अकादमी की ओर से बहुत आभारी हूँ। साहित्य अकादमी और फोसवाल की तरफ से सभी लेखकों के प्रति आभार। इस सत्र में हमारे बीच में मोहम्मद मंसूर नसीमी साहब को होना था, उन्होंने अपना वीडियो भी भेजा था, लेकिन कुछ तकनीकी दिक्कतों की वजह से हमें उसमें चलाने में प्रॉब्लम हुई। हम किसी अन्य सत्र में कोशिश करेंगे कि ये तकनीकी दिक्कत दूर करके हम उनका वीडियो आप तक पहुँचा सकें। इस सत्र में हमारे बीच में अफगानिस्तान से हबीबुल्ला हबीबी और भूटान से एश्विनी लामा, अफगानिस्तान से अफसाना वहेद यार, अफगानिस्तान से अब्दुल्ला दौदजई और मोहम्मद मंसूर नसीमी साहब को होना था। तकनीकी दिक्कतें हैं वहां, इसलिए शायद आप समझ सकते हैं कि कुछ परेशानी हुई है। अब ये सत्र यहीं पर संपन्न होता है। आप सबके प्रति बहुत बहुत आभार, नमस्कार।
बहुत अफसोस की बात है
जी,
इस तरह
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल इस सत्र में कई